Hey guys, I actually have an exciting tutorial for you today. We're going to create a free local RAG chatbot using the brand new Llama 3.2 model, which was just released by Meta. But before we jump in, let me quickly break down what makes Llama 3.2 so exciting. It includes both vision-capable models, like the 11 billion and 90 billion parameter models, as well as lightweight text-only models, like the 1 billion and 3 billion parameter models. The smaller models can run on edge and mobile devices, opening up new possibilities for on-device AI. And these smaller models also have a massive context length of 128,000 tokens, which is perfect for creating a powerful local chatbot that can chat with your own documents. You'll learn how to download and run the model locally using Ollama, and we'll then use the amazing open source platform Flowise to build out our chatbot. By the end of the video, you'll have your very own AI assistant that can access and understand your personal knowledge base. Let's get started. The first thing we want to do is download and run Llama 3.2 on our own machines. For that, we will be using Ollama. So go over to ollama.com, then download Ollama for your operating system. And after that, simply run the file that you just downloaded to install Ollama. You can then go ahead and open up the command prompt or terminal and simply enter Ollama. And if you installed Ollama correctly, you should receive a response similar to this. Now that we've installed Ollama, we can go ahead and download Llama 3. So back on the Ollama website, we can simply search for the model in the search bar by typing Llama 3.2. I'll select the first result. And on this page, we actually get access to the 3 billion parameter model and the 1 billion parameter model. Let's select the 3 billion parameter model and let's copy this run command over here. And back in our terminal, let's paste in that command and press enter. This will now go ahead and download the Llama 3.2 model, but since I've already downloaded it, it's instantly taken me to this prompt to send a message to the LLM. I'll just send something like hello, and if you get a response back, it means the model was downloaded successfully. We can exit out of this by entering /buy. We will create our chatbot in a minute, but I first want to download one more model, which we will use later on in this video. So back in Ollama, search for Gnomic Embed Text. We will use this as our embeddings model later on in this video. But for now, simply copy this command and run it in the terminal. Great. Now that we have both Llama 3.2 and our embedding model downloaded, we can move on to Flowise. If you would like to learn more about using Ollama, I actually do have a dedicated video, which I'll link to in the description of this video. If you're new to Flowise, it's a free open source platform that makes it super simple to create AI applications using a drag and drop interface. Setting up Flowise is super simple. We only have one dependency. Go over to node.js.org and then download Node.js. You can also go ahead and install Node after the file was downloaded. Then all you have to do is open up your command prompt or terminal again and run npx flowise and press enter. You will now be asked if you want to install the Flowise package. Simply press Y and enter. And this will take about a minute to install. Now, in order to run Flowise going forward, all you have to enter is npx flowise start. You will now be able to access Flowise by going to localhost 3000. The first thing I'm going to do is to enable dark mode, as I don't like blinding my audience. We can use Flowise to create all sorts of AI applications, from simple chatbots to advanced multi-agent flows. And I have several videos on my channel going through many different use cases of Flowise. But what we want to do is create a chatbot that can answer questions based on a custom knowledge base. In order to set up this custom knowledge base, we can simply go to document stores and let's create a new document store. And let's give our document store a name. I'll call mine something like custom knowledge base and I'll hit add to create this document store. Let's now open up this document store. We can use these document stores to easily manage our knowledge base. by adding and removing data sources. Let me show you an example of this. In this folder, I have two documents, a Word document and a CSV file. This is just a simple Q&A document for a fictitious restaurant. We also have the CSV file, which contains the menu items and their prices. So let's say that I wanted to upload these two documents to my knowledge base so that my chatbot can answer questions from these documents. Let's start with the Word document. I'll click on Add Document Loader, and here we have many different types of document loaders. We could extract information from Airtable, Confluence, web scrapers, etc. What I want is this docx file. Then I'll select that Word document on my PC. And if I click on Preview Chunks, we will now get one chunk back, which contains all the text in that document. But this is not ideal. These documents can be massive, and it's good practice to break this document up into smaller chunks. This will reduce the token usage. So to split the document, we can simply go down to Text Splitters, and within this dropdown, let's select Recursive Character Text Splitter. We can now set the chunk size to something like 500 characters, and I'll set the chunk overlap to something like 20. Now when we run preview, we can see that we now get 10 chunks back, and these are more bite-sized pieces of text from our document. Lastly, I'll click on Process to finish loading this document. Let's add another document loader for that CSV file. In this list, I'll select CSV file. Let's select it from my PC. I'll leave all the default values, as the CSV file will automatically create a unique chunk for each record in the CSV file. Lastly, I'll click on Process. I hope you can see that document stores make it super easy to add new data sources. And if you ever wanted to remove a data source, we can simply click on Options and delete it. All we have to do now is load these data sources into a vector database. Our chatbot will effectively reach out to the vector database to retrieve the most relevant documents related to the user's query. So to do that, we can click on Upsert Config. And the first step is to select the embeddings model. We will be using Ollama embeddings. Now we just have to specify the model name. And as a reminder, we downloaded this Gnomic embed chat model to perform the embeddings for us. So back in Flowise, we can simply enter Gnomic embed text as the model name. I'll leave the rest of these fields on their default values. And now we just have to select the vector store. And we will be using Flowise in this tutorial. Now all we have to do is provide a path where this Flowise database will be created. So I've simply created this vector folder on my machine, and I'll paste the path to that folder in this field. We can now save our config, and finally we can click on Upsert, and this will now grab all the documents from our document store and load them into our database. And in fact, if I go back to this folder, we can now see this Flowise index was created in this folder. Now, if we wanted to, we could even test this retrieval. And if I enter something like, what are the current specials? This will simulate the retrieval process that our chatbot would execute. And we can see that the four most relevant documents were returned from our document store. Right, so now that we've created our document store and uploaded our documents into a vector index, we can now go ahead and create our RAG chatbot. Let's go to Chatflows, let's click on Add New, and let's give our chatflow a name by saving the chatflow. And let's call it My RAG Chatbot. Let's save this. And let's start by adding a new node to the canvas. And let's go to Chains. And let's add the Conversational Retrieval Chain. That was a mouthful. But this basically means that we can have a back and forth conversation with our chatbot, which also includes memory so that the chatbot can recall information from the conversation history. We can also attach a vector store retriever, and that will allow this QA chain to reach out to a vector database to retrieve information related to the user's question. Let's start by adding the chat model. Under Add Nodes, let's go to Chat Models, and let's add the Chat Ollama node. We can then connect our chat model to our chain. Now for the model name, we can either grab the model name from the Ollama website, or alternatively, if you open your terminal or command prompt, you can enter Ollama list, and this will show all the available models on your machine. And from here, you can simply copy the model name and paste it into this field. We can now set the temperature, and this is a value between 0 and 1. 0 means the model needs to stick to the original prompt, and the value of 1 means the model can have full creative control. I'll enter something like 0.6. Let's also add a memory node to this canvas. So, under memory, let's add the buffer memory node, and let's connect that to our chain as well. The buffer memory node will allow the model to be able to recall information from our conversation history, and this will allow us to ask follow-up questions. Lastly, let's add our vector store retriever. Let's click on Add Nodes, and under vector stores, let's add the document store node, and let's attach this to our chain as well. Now, on the document store, we can simply click on this dropdown and select the document store that we created earlier. And believe it or not, that's actually all we need to create this RAG chatbot. Let's save this flow. Let's test it out by clicking on the chat bubble so we can ask our questions in this window, or we can click on this button to expand this view. Let's enter something like hello. And look at that, we do get a response back. Now, let's ask a question, something that's in the knowledge base, like what are your current specials? And that is 100% correct. Let's also ask a question related to the menu. Like, let's ask it how much the lamb chops are. And we are expecting the answer to be 210 South African rand. So let's enter, how much are your lamb chops? And this is perfect. And this is all running locally on your own machine, absolutely free. And if you ever wanted to adjust your knowledge base, all you have to do is open up the document store, add a new document loader, or delete any of these items. And very importantly, remember to click on Upsert Config and then click on to load the data into your vector database. If you enjoyed this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And check out these other Flowise videos over here. I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.